This is a presentation of WellThatCool.com. Quickly taking over the world. This podcast is made possible by The Left Hand, handmade herbal skincare. You can find them on the internet at thelefthand.net. Also, The Pink Box Burlesque, Tuscaloosa's only burlesque troupe. Find them on the internet at www.pinkboxburlesque.com. And Bel Chev Artisan Goat Cheese, great cheese made from goat milk. You can find them on the internet at belchev.com.
Hi folks, this is TJ Ripp from TowerOfBammer.com, the only sports blog read by my girlfriend and yours. Every week. Okay, I'm gonna be honest here. I'm still reeling from a bit of a hangover this weekend. The game wasn't that great. I have to do a review of the Tulane game and a preview of Western Kentucky. It's just sort of a bummer week. I'm just gonna dial this one in.
We're sorry, your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the number and dial again. This is a recording.
Last week, this previous game was pretty nightmarish. This was the game that we all sort of feared would happen. Our offense looked like crap. Our defense, actually has done okay. I mean, they managed to prevent any touchdowns, but it was still kind of scary for a few moments there. We just didn't look good. Thank God for special teams, but I'm here to, provide some of the silver lining for this week. One being, nobody watched the game. None of the voters, none of the national media watched the game at all. Unlike the Ohio State game or the Notre Dame game, where they were, scraping to beat, really loser teams like, San Diego State. Luckily, those games were watched by everybody. Nobody saw us, so hey, great. This is also the game that we sort of needed to happen at some point in the season. If we blow out Tulane, blow out Western Kentucky, our team's going to be riding high and not really have the gut check that they sort of need to get going. So we're kind of be glad that it happened this early and that it ended with a W. We could be looking at, the same situation as West Virginia. And, they lost to East Carolina, got, dropped back in the polls. That could have been us. We could be looking at the same situation, but we're not. So we're still 2-0. We're ranked number 11th in the nation. So in the end of the week, it looks bad, but it's not all that bad. It's 1 week, one game, and I'm sure that, we'll figure it out and get it together before next week. So let's just jump ahead to next week. This is going to be a three-bladder game. It's on our bladder of bourbon system. So I was going to back it off to two bladders just because, last week was kind of squirrely, so I thought maybe two, but you know what? I trust that this coaching staff's going to coach these guys up and get them together, and it should be the blowout that we expected over Tulane. And also, Western Kentucky, the Hilltoppers, they're not the same team that Tulane is. Tulane's actually, if you remember last year, they were actually competing with LSU at the halftime last year when they played them. So I think Western Kentucky, he's not nearly the team that Tulane is, but that's going to be pretty much, I expect a blowout that, we all wanted. Well, I think that's going to do it for me this week, folks. I told you I was going to dial it in. So short and sweet, but hopefully next week we'll take a look at what happened and preview the Arkansas game, our first real away game that's going to be pretty exciting. So, all right, guys, this is TJ Ripp from Tower of Bammer signing out. Duffel pass. Working on 13, so y'all teams better be back.